Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here. I want to make some videos tonight, but I want to make this one before I forget. This will be, I think, our third or fourth time of sending boxes to the Philippines. I already made this video once. I'm redoing it because it was kind of long, but surprisingly, right? The point is that several times when Americans try to send a box, if you don't know someone or if you're an American born here, your stuff might disappear. It's pretty common. But if you know somebody, you have a contact there, like in the Filipino customs office, or you know someone in the company that ships the boxes, and there's several different shipping companies, and if you they're good, there's a few good ones, and then if you know somebody. So, brothers and sisters, we're going to send everything that you want to send. We're going to send it through Sister Pearly. Thank the Lord that we have a sister who's a Filipino, who is now an American citizen, who has contacts. You know, and she's the sister we've been sending stuff through. And thank the Lord. God has put it on her heart to help us out. So I'll have her information below. It says see more down there below this video. If you click on that, any of my videos, you click on that description, I've got more stuff down there always like that. The website, joshuasministry.com, the Facebook group about the book that the Lord gave me to write, Final Boarding Call. You can also get it on Amazon or Kindle, but I have signed copies if you want to get a copy from me. All this stuff, you know, the proceeds from that goes to the ministry. And the message that the Lord gave me. So anyway, I have the information below to contact Sister Pearly. We need children's summer clothes. So we don't need children's winter clothes. It's like 90 degrees there every day, 365 days a year. Children's school supplies, pencils, papers, all that kind of stuff, crayons, coloring books, anything. Toys, stuffed animals, anything like that. New or used, is not in good condition used. You can send it to Sister Pearly with her address below here, Facebook and all that. And as I was mentioning earlier, let me mention this again. We need to get it to her, but she needs to ship the boxes by the end of October to get it there before Christmas. So it's not really that much notice. You got like 6 weeks at max till December, October 15th at the latest to get the stuff out in the mail to Sister Pearly. And like I said, her information will be below here. You can contact her on her by her email or Facebook. Any questions? Anyway, brothers and sisters, we can consolidate them in boxes, and we can send a box for like $80 and or $90, and it's not by weight. It's just a size, you know. I forget what it is, whatever. It's like 3 feet or 4 feet by 2 feet or whatever it is. And, you know, it can have unlimited weight. Just whatever you can stuff into the box. And we can send those. They go by cargo. It's much cheaper. If you try to send a box, A, number one, your stuff might be stolen and destroyed, get jammed up in customs, and, you know, they're looking for a special fee to get it released, more than what the stuff's worth. And then it ends up going to, you know, I mean, this is how these corrupt countries work. And anyway, it's all bad news, basically. Plus, the cost of sending stuff is going to be outrageous. So, God bless you guys. And like I said, just while I'm making this video, I need to make a slideshow. If you want to find out about the orphanages, we have the two orphanages, and we're feeding 800 kids a week now instead of 500. I need to do a slideshow about that. I've been making a slideshow of music, but I need to make a slideshow talking about it. You know, we still have a one kitchen at the orphanage number two that we haven't finished, and we're still probably about $500 short. I'm finishing that kitchen and the other orphanage and orphanage number two, what we call a dirty kitchen. In the Philippines, just like it used to be in the States, in the South. If any of you guys have been around old houses, they usually have a separate kitchen from the house because of fire and all that kind of stuff, plus the heat. You know, so in the Philippines, you know, people have a dirty kitchen because it's like 100 degrees every day, as I said. And then, of course, because of fire, most of the people are cooking with, at best, you know, rich people cook with a propane tank with a little burning thing, you know, a hot plate, a burner in their house. And then, of course, that's highly dangerous and flammable. And then at the orphanage, we're using wood stoves because we have abundant of wood there. You know, we have the coconut trees. And the coconut trees, they shed chunks of wood, you know, like these pieces that you can get. And then the coconut shells, you can chop those up. You can use those also. So we have our own renewable fuel. And then there's, you know, and I need to make a slideshow about this. A picture's worth a thousand words, right? I'm just going through it as I'm talking. There's also poor people, like old men and women and stuff like that, who are really old and can't do a whole lot. And they'll go get this wood and they'll chop it down into pieces, take off the bark, and then they put it in a little bundle and they tie it up with a piece of like twine. And then they'll sell that for like 2 pennies for a one fire load. You know, it's like 2 pennies per meal that you might cook. And so we buy it from these old poor people, you know. And so all the things we're doing in the Philippines, at every level, we're helping people, brothers and sisters. So even though You know, we do have the orphans and we can collect our own wood and all that too, but for 2 pennies per, so that's 6 pennies a day, I can help some, you know, an old man, like orphanage number one, it's this old man that's like in his 70s and, you know, he don't have any income, there's no retirement there, whatever, no Social Security. They do have a Social Security program that's pretty new, and then you have to buy into it, opt into it. You have to have a job, and you have to pay into it for years and years and years, and then hopefully you'll get something back. But, you know, it's not, like, mandatory, and then, you know, if you have to have, a like, some kind of a real official job. Most people have some kind of, if they do work, it's under the table, casual labor, cash under the table pay. So 90% of the old of the old people, they don't have any kind of support except for their own family. So we're helping this, as an example, we're helping this old guy, you know, at orphanage number one, and we also have somebody, I think it's an older lady at orphanage number two. So anyway, we got all these things going on, brothers and sisters, helping at every level. So God bless you guys. And if you want to go to the Facebook group, you know, you can even, if you don't want to be on Facebook, lots of people don't want to be on there, you can make up an anonymous account, you know, start a Facebook and use a different name. And then, you know, just, but make sure you put some kind of picture in the thumbnail. And because I've been getting spam on the Facebook group, like for sunglasses and all this stuff, and then there's no picture in the thumbnail, so I'm not, you know, approving anymore anyone without a thumbnail picture. That's a red flag that it's some kind of a fake account. So, but you can make an account and then join, and you can see the pictures. I post pictures almost every day of the feeding programs, the orphanages, updates, and you can go there and you can see how to donate. You know, we can receive, you know, people that, there's lots of people that don't want to fool with PayPal. PayPal's the number one way. It's the easiest and the cheapest. We can do Western Union, MoneyGram, and then, of course, while especially while I'm here in the States, even when I go to the Philippines, there's a sister in Bakersfield, California, who's helping me to receive, if anybody sends checks or money orders, she can receive it and deposit it into account. Then I can transfer it to the Philippines, you know. Anyway, so we've got all these different ways, and it's all on the website, which is joshuasministry.com, and that's under every video I make. I put it down in there somewhere. And then there's a lot of people don't know, you can click on that see more and see all this information in the description area. And then, as I said, there's the book. If you want a signed copy, it's patrickwinfrey.com/final boarding call. That's below the video. Proceeds, a signed copy and the proceeds go to the orphanage. If you don't want a signed copy, you can get an Amazon. You know, a lot of people now do Kindle. You can get a Kindle copy on Amazon or barnesandnoble.com. As I mentioned again, the Facebook group is probably the most active. We have the website, joshuasministry.com, and I put like a bio and pictures of each orphan and all this, but it's also mirrored on Facebook. It seems to be the Facebook group is the best because, you know, you can interact and comment and all that, where the website, you know, it's just not that interactive. But I have the static information on there of how to donate and all that, the details of PayPal and how to do it and all that kind of stuff. So anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you guys. I've got some more videos to make the Lord's given me, so I want to get this out today so we can get the ball rolling. Like I say, you only got about 6 weeks to send stuff. God bless you guys. Thank you to all those who have helped so far with Joshua's ministry. You know, and then as I mention every once in a while, and everybody knows, you get people that are trolls on your channel and all these wacky comments. You know, not all this. You get, you know, you have every video I make, I probably say you have one troll and mean person, atheist or some cult member, some, you know, Seventh-day Adventist, any kind of thing that you might get that's attacking, you know, all about doctrine, doctrine, doctrine. But in reality, brothers and sisters, it boils down to being, you know, if we, like the song, by casting crowns, if we are the body, you know, why aren't his feet going? Why aren't his hands healing? You know, so we as the body of Christ, brothers and sisters, we're supposed to manifest the love of Christ in this world. It's not just here and all talk, blah, 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 and all these theories and all this debating about doctrines, but to be the hands and feet of Christ, take the love of Christ to people. And that's what Joshua's ministry is all about. So what keeps me going, of course, is the Lord. But other than the Lord, the only thing that keeps me going, you know, is knowing that I'm doing God's will. And I'm a servant of God. I'm a pastor. I'm doing God's will. And all the pie-in-the-sky theories and debates and arguments of all of this foolishness on YouTube is going to be meaningless, for one thing. At best, it'll be meaningless on Judgment Day. At worst, those people's going to be ashamed, bowing their heads in humility and ashamed when they stand before the Lord, and the Lord is going to be like, hey, You know, why didn't instead of spend all your time on the internet debating and trolling and making obnoxious comments and rude remarks on people's videos, why were you not out here building orphanages in the Philippines or feeding homeless people in your own hometown, you know, working at a soup kitchen and telling people about Jesus and telling people about me, as the Lord would say? You know, why weren't you working at a food closet or donating to a food closet? Why weren't you serving me? You know, a lot of people say they don't want to give to the church they go to because the church wants to build. As an example, I know several people like this. A brother and sister has just came in my mind. You know, their church wants to build a big old padded pew church and then start talking about the, you know, about the environment instead of the gospel. You know, those people, we need to flee from those people. You know, we need to, you know, go and do where God called us to. And everything brings glory to God and to the gospel message, to win people to Christ. Whether it be, like I said, in your hometown, start a soup kitchen, start a lending closet, you know, to give people food and clothes and stuff like that. And then for them to get it, they got to sit through an hour-long presentation about the gospel. They don't want to sit through the presentation. They don't get anything. But a lot of churches, especially your inner-city ministries, that's why President Bush, you know, the genius of the Illuminati, they started that faith-based initiative. What does that mean? They give money to poor inner-city churches, and then later on they tell the poor inner-city church, oh, you can't say nothing against gay marriage. Oh, we're going to pull your funding. Oh, you can't say people got to hear about Jesus before they get to free food. We, the government, gave you that food to give to people. So therefore, hey, you have to say what we tell you to say. Brothers and sisters, that's why we, the body, need to provide. If the church was doing its job, we wouldn't need no welfare. If the church was doing its job, we wouldn't need no Medicare and all this kind of stuff, Medicaid and all that. It's just the job of the church, brothers and sisters. The church has been doing it all the way up till they bought the lie that the government is God in the 1960s, the war on poverty and all this, when the government came in and said, oh, we're going to solve all your problems and better living through government, replacing God with government. I mean, that's where you get your communism and fascism and all that stuff, all those isms. God bless you guys. Flee from churches that try to do anything but spread the gospel by any means necessary. We should be spreading the gospel by any means necessary. I started preaching. God bless you guys. I love you guys. Thank you for all the help of all who are helping us to help me to try to do what God wants done over there with the Philippines. And I try.